Hello everyone, so in this video we are going to talk about Horner's syndrome. Now this condition is seen due to cervical sympathetic chain involvement, and there is involvement of oculosympathetic fibers, that is the sympathetic fibers that supply in and around the eyeball. Now these fibers go through three routes, that is the fibers that are going through the third cranial nerve and supplying the molar muscle that helps in elevation of the upper eyelid, the long ciliary nerve that is going to supply the dilator pupillae, okay, through carries along the third nerve, the nasociliary nerve that supplies the blood vessels of the eye. Now the characteristic clinical features can be remembered by a mnemonic sample: the sympathetic chain involvement, anhydrosis, meiosis, ptosis, loss of ciliospinal reflex, and enophthalmos. You can also understand it by these features, that the palsy of the molar muscle will lead to decreased elevation of the upper eyelid, leading to ptosis. The dilated pupillae palsy will lead to meiosis, and the other feature involving are because of loss of cervical sympathetic chain. The causes involve the cerebral and the brainstem lesions. Now all these lesions or the causes somehow disrupt the cervical sympathetic chain, leading to the following features. The cerebral and brainstem lesions may be cerebral infarction and the brainstem demyelination. Also there can be cervical cord lesions, that may be syringomyelia, or the cord tumors, that may be ependymoma and glioma. It can also occur following a thyroid laryngeal or a carotid surgery and a carotid artery dissection. Neoplastic infiltration in and around the oculosympathetic tract can also lead to the same thing. There is a thing that is known as congenital Horner syndrome, and it can be idiopathic, and somehow you should also remember cluster headaches that may lead to Horner syndrome. So this is what you needed to know about Horner syndrome for a short note. Thanks for watching.